Welcome back, everyone, to the second part of today's episode of The Burning Wheel Patronage. We just had a hell of a roll. Yep. I don't know how you passed that.
With great skill.
Yeah.
Yeah, skill and not booty.
Booty is skill?
Mm-hmm.
I'm carrying a lot of boxes up and down stairs to get this booty.
Did you use the seduction fork or not?
Yes, I did.
You did? Okay.
I did.
Great.
That's how I got up to 7 dice.
Yes.
My difficult persuasion test.
Great.
I only have 1 fate and 1 persona left.
Yeah, I will.
Which is how hard I went to win this goddamn roll.
Your thing on the overlay.
Dear.
There you go. So, yeah, so he stops and he looks you up and down, and then he looks you up and down.
Yeah. I love that this is how we convey flirting, is we say a thing, and then we say it again with some emphasis.
Yes. And he says, yes, I think you may do. What is it that you do, Mr.
Astoranza? And I put out a hand. Is the handshake the thing of the time?
Kiss on both cheeks.
That comes later. Wait.
Oh no, please, can it be kiss on both cheeks? Because I can't reach people to do it.
Yes.
I love it.
Sure, okay.
Sorry, but yeah,
that's
kind of fun. Yeah. So you kiss both cheeks, and he.
Linger a little long. Cool. And as for what I do, I'm a playwright and actor. I run a theater in the piazza, and I am looking for places to perform to spread the word of my works. And, well, I didn't make the money to open a theatre of my own by being bad at my job. Mm-hmm.
He does the smile and nod again. Uh-huh. He acknowledges that he found your thing funny. But it is not in his, like, social station to laugh.
Sure.
Cool. And he says, there may be an opening in my master's small gathering for a demonstration. I don't know if I can give you a full performance.
An opportunity is all I require. He doesn't pause. Finmar is doing that. Master Galliano, I promise that a taste is all they will require to want ever more.
Laying it on thick.
Yes. And he nods, says, I'll be in contact within the day for the details.
Wonderful. And I gesture again at my theatre and goes, you know where to find me.
And he says, yes. Yes, I do.
Cool.
And he walks off.
Wonderful. I bow as he leaves.
Mm-hmm. And the camera follows Lorenzo, and again we get the, like, characters crossing.
Passes, like, you just see, like, a bobbing head. And the camera just goes down.
Yes, so I think like the camera like is over like looking down over his shoulder, and then we follow Alov. So we get to see our dwarf for the first time.
Yes, I have an idea of what situation he's in.
Yeah.
Not one to his benefit.
Yes.
So I figure a nearby tavern or pub has set up an area outside in the piazza for people to sit with maybe those little... Would they have those parasol things? Yeah, but they wouldn't do the like easier
potentially
fixed. So they've made like a little impromptu beer garden. And some of the locals have heard that dwarves are really good at drinking, so he's being pressured into a drinking contest.
Okay, great.
But he wasn't in dwarven society long enough to actually learn those skills.
So you don't have drinking.
I don't have drinking or drinking. So I'm trying to play it up because I've got the reputation for being the dwarf. So I have to act dwarven. So I'm trying to like drink all these guys under the table, basically.
Okay.
I don't really stand to gain very much except to live up to my reputation. But yeah, just imagine it's a bunch of different people like egging me on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you mainly found yourself surrounded by men and women who are they're all sailors that have come up from the port on like shore leave.
Oh god, actual sailors, they probably got drinking.
And they are yeah, they've occupied an area of this outdoor like seating area, and you are sat at a table opposite a big like burly man with like rippling chest muscles from hauling ropes all day.
He has a tattoo of himself drinking.
And someone puts down like two like shot glasses of rum or whatever the like period equivalent of rum would be. Probably rum.
Yeah, I mean, if you've named the city, they can have. I know how much you like your rum.
Yeah, how much gin?
Oh, there's gin. Yeah. So sitting opposite him is Alof, who stands out in as much as that he is considerably shorter and stockier than most people here. This guy's pretty tough, pretty built, but so is Alof. He's not incredibly strong, but he's worked a long time as a smith, so he's definitely got those upper arm muscles.
Mm-hmm.
He's got a magnificent black beard that reaches, you know, just below his belt. Mm-hmm. It kind of spreads wide across most of his chest, under which you can see a leather apron festooned with different hammers, pliers, bits and bobs. And I'm carrying three toolkits on me. Like at all times, so, and I imagine one of them is like a big, what looks like two-handed hammer, like slung across his back. It's not actually a weapon. It's for black iron artifice, but it looks like it could do some damage.
Mm-hmm.
He keeps his hair covered with kind of like a do-rag. Just to keep out of the way. And he has one of his most prized possessions, aside from his tools, is this pair of sturdy dwarven boots, which have visible like metal plates over the toes.
Mm-hmm.
They know how to make sure that your feet stay safe handling the metals. And apart from that, he's probably got gloves tucked into his belt, and you can see like very hairy forearms, big mm-hmm. meat hands he uses to hold things.
Mm-hmm.
So it's probably both of them struggling a little to be dainty with these, like, glass cups.
Mm-hmm. They're probably not glass. They're probably like pottery or
like
clay.
Yeah, but they look much smaller than
yes, they look smaller in your hands.
And I think Aylov's nose is already a little bit getting a little bit red. His cheeks are getting there mm-hmm. as well. He's trying to keep up the facade, but
yes. And so yeah, there's this like much scrawnier guy that's like filled the cups, and he says to you, "Come on then, dwarf, show us what you're made of."
Cyan in my blood. Well, I suppose there was. It's my father's name. I can't use my name. No. It's time for drinking, not reminiscing. Just another two.
Mm-hmm.
One.
Okay, so I guess this is probably a versus test.
Sure.
Are you drinking or are you drunk?
Yeah, that was the question I was going to ask.
Oh god, I don't know.
So one is not showing you're drunk. One is loudly.
Yeah, these people expect me to not get drunk, so I'm drinking.
Okay.
Yeah. If I was with other dwarves, it's not about showing off that. It's seeing who can get the most drunk the fastest.
Yes.
And I'm doing the opposite right now.
Yeah. Okay.
So drinking is based on fort, which fort, I think I'm actually pretty decent with. Yeah. Yep. Six. So.
And so this guy probably has drinking because he is a sailor.
That's fair.
Feels like a thing sailors would have.
There's definitely a bit in the book about like ballparking skills for NPCs, but I don't know where it is.
Well, like, his fort is probably one of his better ones if he's a sailor, so like 4 or 5, which would open drinking at 2.
Yeah, he's probably like 2 or 3.
Yeah, so he's probably got like free drinking and then maybe like a rum wise fork.
Yeah.
So he's gonna roll 4d6.
Yeah, this was fine.
Wow. So he gets four successes.
Thank you.
And so that's doubled for you because you're
Yeah, I've got to get 8 successes.
You've got to get 8 successes on 6 dice.
I believe.
Yeah, nothing rolling into that. Let's just keep that going.
You got this.
This is probably like actually a fort test in the end, isn't it?
Yeah.
As opposed to the drinking one. Base obstacles.
Base obstacle is 4.
Oh, base obstacle is still 4, so it might not be.
No.
Did my best.
Yeah.
But in the end.
Yeah, so this guy just drinks you under the table. And all the sailors are laughing and they're like, "Ah, I thought dwarves were meant to be able to hold their alcohol."
To be fair, the distance to under the table is much shorter for you.
One of them probably makes that joke. And
I'm ashamed.
Like one of the sailors helps you back up onto your chair. And then the guy across from you He says, "Now, big dwarf, little dwarf, dwarf, I think I deserve a prize for my winning."
Oh. Do we bet on this? I've never been a betting man. That doesn't sound like something I would have said.
I specifically remember. Maybe remember betting that I could drink a dwarf under the table.
Ah, yes, but you didn't. You made that bet against somebody else, not me. Perhaps.
But I don't remember who that was.
Well, the way I see it, where are you? Yes, how about... Actually, no, he's not going to offer. He's greedy. He's not going to give this guy shit.
Mm.
7 million resources. Yeah.
I'd be like, my guy. Yes, dwarves grant wishes. I'll grant you a wish.
And he says, "That hammer on your back, I want it."
Oh, no. Look, you've done very well. Everybody is very impressed with you here. I've brought shame to my clan, and that's something you can tell them about. This hammer, no, it's not worth anything. It just looks bigger because I'm smaller. It's nothing else.
There's a roll there.
All right, I'm trying to soothing platitudes in. That's what
yeah.
I'm saying.
Yeah, I think that's probably the one.
Is there a disadvantage because I'm drunk?
No, because you're both drunk.
Okay, that's
Where is soothing platitudes? Where is O in the alphabet?
Why are you after M?
There it is. There it is. Soothing. Base obstacle is the victim's will.
Yeah. His will probably isn't great.
Yes.
It's an enmity circle. So
yeah, so let's say this is an ob 3.
Okay, I got 3 dice. I'm gonna fork in. I have been playing up to all of his friends how great he is, and they can tell him he beat me. Can I fork oratory?
Yeah, you're definitely making a performance of it to more than just him.
Alright, sweet. I think that's it. So modifiers 1. Arthur, nah. Obstacle. Like, if it comes to it and he fights me, I'm gonna fight. That seems fine.
God.
Yeah, what is the failure condition? Because I'll fight a sailor. I'll do it.
Yeah, I think that probably is the failure, right? Like he's gonna, he'll probably punch you and try and take it from you.
Oh, my power actually kind of sucked. I'll give it a go. Alright, here we go.
Hey, you did it. Also, my map disappeared for Dang. Some reason. Real tiny, what are you doing?
Easy.
Easy peasy.
You soothe as well as this guy drinks.
So he says you're probably right. Yes, yeah. It's probably a very small hammer. Won't fit in my big hands.
Oh no, you have such big and strong hands. And I look at his friends and they're probably just laughing at it.
And he laughs and he like claps you on the back. And says, another round.
Oh, I've got to get back to making those, what was it your friends asked me for? Horseshoe? Wait, no, not. Do boats have shoes?
One of them who is, like, not drunk, or as drunk, says, the rigging! The rigging for the ship!
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Some nails and screws and such like. Yes, many, many nails and screws.
Yes. And rings for the rope to go through.
Rings and rungs both. You're right, you are, Master. I'll get to work on those. Right away. And I get up and I waddle off.
Mm-hmm.
Back over to my workshop, because I own one of these workshops. So I get to work. Everybody else is partying and stuff. So how ill-advised it is to light up a forge in the middle of a party. Probably quite a lot, but I guess I don't consider that.
Who knows?
Let's make some nails. I'll probably give him some shitty nails because I feel bad.
Yeah.
But I lost.
So what are we... What skill are we rolling here?
This your black metal craft?
Yeah, I'm just not doing a good job, so I'm not using any of the extra magical... BS.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, black metal craft is kind of inherently a little bit magical, I think. Like a little bit.
I'm just not increasing the quality of it, which is the...
Yeah. Yeah. You're just using it as regular old blacksmithing.
Yes. Even the pots and horseshoes with intense quality.
Yeah, so if he desires, he may increase the odd by 2 to grant final product special plus 1D. So you don't have to do that.
Yeah.
So this is just an odd one.
Bonk, bonk, bonk. Oh, this is open ended as well. Holy shit. I never fail these really routine tests, do I? Okay.
That's a bold claim.
Yeah. We'll see. Do I want to fork anything? Nah. Seems fine.
You did it. You did it. Well done.
I was waiting for that. You smash your own hand with a hammer.
Yeah. So we get a. We get a short like vignette of Alov starting the forge, getting to work making these bits and bobs for this group of sailors, and then we cut.
The clanging becomes like part of the backing soundtrack of the rest of the people singing, making merry as it like zooms out.
So we cut, I think, to Sophia.
Yeah.
Do you have a thing you want to be doing?
Yeah, I'm just thinking. I feel like I want to actually be. Also, I realized I didn't need to go and get a pastry.
your instinct allows you to just have a pastry.
Yeah. But I think she's going to like be frustrated and go and like do or like start working on something on an art piece or something to like display in the piazza like publicly.
Mm-hmm.
Because yeah, she definitely wants to have that the party that's going on. And this is the thing, right? Like, it should take her much, like, if she's going to work on something that's actually good, it should take her a long time. But she's just going to be like, no, I'm going to go and make an art right now. And I'm going to put it in the piazza and everyone's going to go, wow.
Yeah, yeah. So this is one of the things I wanted to talk about earlier, actually, is most of the, like, artistic skills. So, like, sculpting and painting are, like, weeks for a single test.
Yeah.
And so what we'll probably do is when you want to create something that's like significant, we'll like roll the dice and then have it like unfold as other stuff is happening.
Yeah.
So like you'll set it up and then in a few sessions we'll have, now you've finished doing your grand painting.
Yeah, I think if that's the case, then I want to get a better feel for where I'm at as far as, I want to make a more informed decision about like who I need to impress and all those sorts of things. So I'm definitely like wandering around the parties and things, the celebrations.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, she's trying to get an understanding for, you know, who is who is the most influential, who has the most money, who is the most popular, those sorts of things.
Mm-hmm. So this,
which
to
I don't
me
think I have a skill for.
Sounds like a gossip wise.
Yeah, test. Which I don't know if I have actually. I was looking at my sheet and I think I've done this correct. Did I get, is gossip wise that I actually, the one that I actually opened? Yes, I did. Good. Cool.
Yeah.
So that's two. All right. Because I think I put some in there that I wasn't supposed to because I haven't actually opened them.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, gossip-wise, I've got... cool, all right. So yeah, I'm trying to work out who's who in the parties.
Mm-hmm.
That's my kind of like my question that I'm trying to find the answer to.
Yeah, that just sounds to me like a, like just looking for like surface level information sounds like an odd one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
another one test.
Right. Well then I will. Yeah, I don't think I need to do anything additional to try and get anything else in there. No, I'm just gonna roll it. Press button, please. There we go. No modifiers. Base obstacle is one.
Whoop!
Yay!
You did it. Yeah. So who is who? Who's the person?
Yeah, do you want to do that or am I doing it?
We can do it together.
Okay, cool. I think I like to imagine that there's some person who's like recently entered the scene.
Mm-hmm.
That is important, right? That I don't already know about. And I'm like, oh, that person's a person that needs to be paid attention to.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they're from out of town. Maybe they are like one of these rising merchant families.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they need to be flirted with as per my instinct.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm. So let me have a quick look at my list of names here.
Do we say whether this person is like a prominent artist or are they like a patron?
I don't think so. So you
have heard
that there is a noble lady in the piazza. She She goes by the name Stella Bellini.
Excellent.
Stella. And you've heard, supposedly, that she is commissioning a portrait of her son.
Well, well, well. I need to find this person. I need to run into them accidentally.
Mm-hmm.
By pure chance.
Yes.
Luckily
we have rules for that.
I mean, like, it's definitely a thing of like, yeah, she's specifically seeking this person out and wants to be like, oh, I didn't notice you there. So yeah.
Yes.
Cool. So where am I? How am I doing this?
So, this is a circles test.
Yeah.
You definitely share circles with this person because you have noble court and they have noble court.
Yeah, where do I find circle? Where do I press buttons for a circles test on the sheet?
It's in the stats and skills page. It's like the second row down, I think.
Attributes.
Yes. Attributes. Circles, I found it. Cool.
Yeah.
All right, so I share circles because she's nobly.
Mm-hmm.
So that allows the test.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What is circles based off?
How many resource points you spent.
Starting circles is half a will exponent rounded down, plus 1d if 50 more resources are spent on. So you didn't spend 50 or more resources on that. So it's just half your will rounded down.
So two.
Two. Yeah.
I don't think any of us even had that many resource points.
No, I think I had 55, but I needed tools.
So, that could be two. All right, cool. Yeah. So what are we looking for as far as Ob?
Specific person. There's a set of questions.
Yes, you are looking for a specific person.
Mm-hmm.
Plus one. So we're at two.
They don't have a specific job or anything. It's just a... They're a lady, you're a lady.
Let's see what happens.
Can it be any more obvious?
This is a normal place for them to be on this day.
Yeah.
Are they a higher rank than you?
It's probably two.
My rank is really confusing.
Yes, because you're adopted and you married into a family.
Yep. I got adopted into a rich, low standing family, mm-hmm. and then married into a poor, high standing family. Yes.
So she is definitely a higher rank or station class.
Yeah, that makes sense.
That's plus
two.
And I think that's probably it. So we're looking at an R4?
Yep.
Yeah. All right. Cool. Cool, 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 cool. No doubt, no doubt, no doubt.
Yeah, the only things you can pop in here are reputations or affiliations, if you have those.
I have a reputation. I'm not sure it's going to help me.
What is it?
My reputation is for being a firebrand.
Is it with an ability?
It's among the piazza.
She's here for gossip about the piazza, so.
Okay. Nah, alright, okay. I'm gonna do it. I'm press the button.
You got this.
Ob 4. Do you want to spend. No, you know what? I don't want to spend anything on this. Ob 4. All right, cool. Let's do it. With two dice.
Hey, you got both of your dice.
I'm 100% going to...
Oh my god, if this happens, holy shit.
I believe.
Oh, there's another six there.
One more.
Yes!
Oh, how has this happened twice?
We're just so good at role-playing games.
Jammy. Oh, I'm sorry. My breasts.
Okay.
Now, does that what kind of test does that count as? That counts as.
That is a challenging circumstance.
Challenging.
Excellent. Great.
Yeah. Well done.
Two tests off pass getting a three circles.
So what happens is you and Martin are Martin has like pulled you over to a like an outdoor like gallery setup, so there's a bunch of paintings that are on like stands, and their artists are nearby and mingling, and Martin has pulled you over to a sort of like a relief of the, I think it's like a battle, some battle scene between armies. You think there's like two groups of people, and there's like people dying in the middle, and I don't know like how into like war art Sophia is.
I mean, she's totally like there being like, ah yes, this is very traditional. I can see that it contains a lot of men.
And Martin is explaining to you the battle that it is, and who the generals were, and is pointing them out, and
is Martin like a meek but excited, or is he a mansplainer? Like which
No, he's meek but excited. He's a he's a really big nerd. He's an alchemist.
Yeah.
His whole thing is that he's like a shit Da Vinci. His favorite thing to do is hide away in his cave and be like, what happens if I take bat guano and salt and mix them together? Ah, nothing happened. I'll write that down. Right? Like,
Da Shitchi.
Great.
Da Shitchi.
Can I turn shit into gold?
I've tried with 40 different reagents. So far, no luck. But I'm sure 41 will be successful. Or at least do something.
Oh god. Okay, so Martin is explaining this to you. Excitedly, and he's
big... Is this totally like a recent relief of like one of the first battles where gunpowder was decisive?
Yes.
Because that would be a thing, right?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So he's telling you about he begins telling you about how the cannons were laid out and where they were positioned, and going into the details of how the cannons were instrumental in the victory.
He's like explaining this to me, and I'm like, but they're all in a line. I can see it there. They're in a line. And he's like, no, but they weren't really. This is for the art. And she's like, it's all very strange.
But your attention is drawn away from the painting, and you see a very beautiful woman. She's probably in her late 40s, maybe going on 50. And she's wearing a very like delicate, very delicate dress. very light for the weather. And she's followed around by two servant girls, who are, one of them's holding holding a small bag of important items, and then the other is sort of moving ahead and like making sure people aren't like getting in the way of this very important woman. And I think maybe you recognize her description definitely, but also maybe you've seen her at a one of these like noble parties, but haven't like spoken to her before. And she's currently looking at a portrait of I think probably like a cardinal sat reading like a big book.
Yeah, I'm going to sidle, get into her like peripheral vision so that like she's not noticing me.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to pretend like I'm looking at these paintings, like the other paintings that are nearby. And then I'm going to speak to the artist who I probably at least I'm going to pretend to know them, if not actually know them. I'm going to be like, Dante, I understand that you don't like the cardinal, but you've been very unflattering in this painting. Look at this. His belly roll is over the book. You mustn't do this. And she's like, what will potential buyers think?
And the artist is like, no, that's just the rolls in the fabric. I'm so sorry.
Dante, have you drawn him with three legs?
Wow.
There's a role here.
Conspicuous forking professional sabotage wise.
I feel like I am beginners looking conspicuous again. I might be forking in like etiquette as like knowing
the wrong thing to do.
Yeah, exactly. I'm making it look like he's bad at etiquette, right? Like at is my intention.
Mm-hmm.
I'm definitely forking in painting though. Oh wait, no, I can't because it's beginner's luck. Fuck me. All right, cool.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. It sounds like it. I'm trying to get her attention.
Yeah. I think we can do that.
Cool.
Yeah. So I think it will just be Ob one.
Okie doke. Let's try. Really
trying to get a single person's attention.
Yeah. I mean, I've got a chance. Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
Nice.
Sorry, Dante.
Yeah, and so Dante's like trying to apologize to this noble lady, like trying to talk over you, disparaging his painting.
But obviously, Dante, I don't understand these sorts of things. You know, your style is much more traditional. If I need someone to paint someone from old, I would love to get you to do that. Yeah, my style is obviously a lot more modern and evocative. So you know, that's
and Stella
anatomically correct.
Stella looks at you and says, "Oh my dear, you're an artist as well."
She's hobbyist only. Obviously, I do dabble. I do a little bit of sculpture, a little bit of painting. My husband is an alchemist. Comes up with some of the finest hues. She's like some of the colors that I get to use I've not seen on other things. It's very exciting.
Oh, that does sound wonderful. I do love artists. I love art in general, you know.
She's like art and artists are so easy to love. Is Martin still looking at the gun thing?
Yes. Yes, he probably hasn't noticed you've walked away and is explaining the painting to someone else, probably the painter.
He's probably
explaining historical inaccuracies to an artist.
Yes.
Yep.
Good.
So Stella,
if you'd like, if you're interested in those sorts of things, I'd love to show you some of my work. I'm sure it's nothing like you've ever seen before.
I think there's a persuade test.
In go for the advantage by bribing her with tasty treats.
I mean, it worked for me.
Croissant.
Yeah, I feel like there's definitely a persuade test in
the... That definitely sounds like a persuade. I don't have it. Let's do it. Let's.
This is gonna be real hard.
That's worse.
Yeah.
This is gonna be incredibly difficult.
Does she have really good will?
No. I don't think she has very... She's not, like, exceptionally high. I think her will is probably 4.
Great!
Have fun with your orb 8 persuasion test! How much will do you have?
5.
Okay. Good luck with that.
Uh-huh.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. So that'll be a up for beginner's luck persuade test.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Look, let's just you play the game.
Yes.
Play the game of flirt.
I'm definitely spending. I'm gonna go for it.
You're gonna try and do it again.
Sure.
I want
5 more
dice on our 5.
You need 5 more successes on 2 dice.
I mean, if you want, just to put a fate into your, I guess,
yes.
that's a difficult
to will. Yeah.
Yeah, because it's a difficult will test.
Yeah.
So your will gets that rather than your persuasion.
I'm gonna let it sit.
Okay. Yeah, so I guess what's the failure here?
So my intention was to like get her to want to like was to like lead her down the path of like eventually hiring me.
Mm-hmm.
By bringing her to my to see my work.
Yeah, so she says I think she says, well, I'm sure your colours are wonderful, my dear, but right now I am looking for something more traditional. Dante's misplaced fat rolls and all.
Yeah, and she's like, yeah, and I'm like, well then, Dante is definitely the right person for what you're looking for. In fact, if you come over here, you can see some of his works that are not for the clergy, which are much more flattering. And I'm gonna like actually try and like help Dante get the sale then, because I don't actually want him to hate me. But yeah, I just like, you know, I don't know if I'm specifically intending to do a thing here, just like that's where I'm putting you on, right? Like I'm like, okay, like let's dial it back into
yeah, so if this test then is to make it so Dante doesn't help you, I think it's a soothing platitudes.
Sure.
On Dante.
Yeah, I can do that.
Because you're trying to be like, oh, but look at all this other work, isn't it very nice?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, cool, great. Can I fork painting in?
Yes.
Okay.
So... and this is ob-free.
Cool. So, all right. So, where do I put the fork in? If I've got three in painting, where it comes up with...
So when you open it up,
yeah,
it'll say modifiers. You just put... one for the fork.
Yep. Cool. I'm just wondering if there's anything else that I can... Etiquette can't fork here, can it?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, alright, let's do it. What was the ob you said?
Free.
Okie doke. This is probably not going to be great. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nope.
Great. Okay. Fuck you, Dante.
Yeah. So Dante.
I need to pick up arson.
that's your next step.
The logical next step. Yep.
I like it.
So Dante like sneers at you. Sophia, I can sell my own paintings. Thank you very much.
Yeah, and I'm like, if you could sell your own paintings, Dante, you wouldn't be living in a closet, and like storm off.
Okay.
You bother to collect your husband, or do you leave him?
why would I bother to collect him?
He probably sees you walking off, and is like, oh, Sophia.
Yeah, and I'm like, Martin, I'm busy, and like, I'm not. I'm just leaving.
Yeah. How dare you speak to me in public?
God damn it, Sophia! I hate you already.
Okay. Shall we take another break?
Sure.
And then.
Yep. Sounds good.
Yeah. Okay. Stick around, everyone. We'll be back in a few minutes and we'll continue seeing how these trash people live their lives.
Hey, that's rude.